Hey everybody, welcome back. That's right, second video on the second day. Back-to-back uploads, baby. And tonight, we're going to play Counter-Strike Global Offensive. You're going to watch as that game ruins my friendships and my life. So check me out tonight at 8:30 Eastern for CSGO Escaping Silver, either on this YouTube channel or on twitch.tv/ohnoitsalex. And now that the shameless plug is over, let's talk about Xbox doing one of the best things they've done in a very long time. We're going to look at how Xbox is now providing an FPS boost to their backwards compatible games. And this is something that I'm loving to see. And I really hope that Sony follows suit. Because we all know the PS5 is backwards compatible with a lot of their older games as well. And seeing things like God of War 2018 run at a much better frame rate and at a lock 60 is super awesome to see everyone enjoy that. Especially as so many people were looking at 30 FPS being the standard, when in reality, 60 should be the minimum. Let's take a look at what Xbox has done and we'll go from there. So making backwards compatible games even better with the FPS boost. When we were designing the Xbox Series X and S, we wanted to continue our commitment to compatibility when we started back in 2015. Enabling gamers to play their favorite titles from past gens on new consoles. Nearly all titles benefit from next-generation features, loading times, quick resume, etc. And then the team went one step further, adding enhancements to many of our most played games, so they look and feel play better than ever before. As we detailed in October, with the increased CPU and GPU and memory from our new consoles, all of your existing games look and play better. With certain titles, we can make the experience even better, all with no work required by the dev and no update required by you, the gamer. To that end, the backwards compatibility team has developed FPS Boost, which employs a variety of new methods to nearly doubling and in a few games, quadrupling the original frame rate on select titles. Higher frame rates make games visually smoother, resulting in more immersive gameplay. We partner closely with devs to enhance the experience while maintaining the game's original intent, and while not applicable to all games, these new techniques can push the engines to render more quickly for a buttery smooth experience at 60 FPS minimum or even sometimes 120 FPS. This is so good to see. It is unbelievable how good this actually is. And I hope, man, I pray that Sony does the exact same thing to their backwards compatible games. That ability to bring back and play their older games at a better frame rate is exactly what so many people need right now. These new consoles have a few exclusives and then nothing else behind it. So you know what? Older games are what people should be playing now too. Games they missed out on, games they couldn't play before, games that they tossed to the side. All that stuff should be available to you right now. And with that being said, having a better box, having more hardware, having that space, having that SSD, the GPU, the CPU, the SoC, all being much more powerful than the previous gen, there's no reason why these games should not have had this option available to them from the beginning. These consoles are x86 architecture. They're practically PCs through and through. They're just in a closed box and they got a logo from a company on them. That's pretty much it. There's really not much else separating consoles from PCs anymore. So in my opinion, this should go one step further. This should go to the point where people have the ability to actually granularly adjust the settings of every game, just like we do on PC. There's no reason why it shouldn't be there in the first place. You know what? You can keep the performance mode options, you can keep the resolution mode options, but provide an advanced mode where the player can go in, see all the actual settings that they want to adjust, turn on, turn off, increase, decrease, to tailor the game the way they want to play it. That way, things like FPS Boost aren't really necessary anymore. And even though things are designed for an SoC, you're practically on a PC right now anyways. I mean, you're using AMD architecture. What's the difference? It's negligible. So this should be the next step that happens in the next gen, or hopefully even this gen. Just providing players with those graphical options that they should have from the very beginning so they can customize their own experience. This, however, is a very cool first start. Let's continue with the article. We're excited to announce the first assortment of backwards compatible titles that will support FPS Boost, available beginning today. Far Cry 4, Super Lucky's Tale, Sniper Elite 4, UFC 4, and Watch Dogs 2. We chose this initial collection of titles not only because they are popular among fans, but to highlight several different ways the FPS boost can improve your experience. For example, Super Lucky's Tale can now run up to 120 FPS, and UFC 4 delivers improved frame rate performance, specifically designed on the Series S, can now run at 60 FPS. That's killer. That's absolutely killer across the board. This is such a great thing to see. I cannot stop gushing about this whole concept, because we've had this on the PC for a very, very long time. You get a new GPU, the first thing you do is you play that old game that gave you a hard time on that old GPU, and you run that son of a bitch as fast as you can with everything turned on to the maximum at a blistering 144 FPS or even more. That's the fun about getting new hardware on PC, is going back to those older games that gave you a hard time and seeing what they were really made out of and playing them at a frame rate that is just wild and crazy. And that's what I want to have so many other people experience when they go back to play their older games, and why I want so many people to have those granular options in the game settings. So this is honestly a great first step, but let's continue. This is just the beginning. We will announce and release more titles featuring FPS Boost soon as we roll out the new menu icons and system settings in an upcoming system update. Starting this spring, you can go into the Manage Game section of any title. You'll be presented with a new Compatibility Options button that will allow you to toggle FPS Boost as well as Auto HDR on or off. There'll be a new indicator informing you of when the game is running with FPS Boost whenever you hit the Xbox button on your controller. You decide how you want to play your favorite games, whether it's in original form or with the FPS boost. That is, again, super, super cool, because you can see it pretty clear here on the screenshot. FPS boost is on the right-hand side under the time, and it's just such a great, great feature. I'm like gushing about this because I want this kind of stuff to be standard. Just to be standard, right? If you got 60 FPS as the standard, then you move from there. And your gaming experience just gets better across the board, regardless of whatever game you're playing. If people think animations look good at 30 FPS, I don't know what they're going to think when they see animations at 60, or even 120, or even 240. Like, it just gets better every single time. An FPS boost doesn't only benefit gamers who own these titles. You'll be happy to hear that many of these upcoming FPS boost games will be available on Xbox Game Pass. Yo, they are just... Look, after the flub they made with trying to raise the price of Xbox Live Gold, this is the right move that they should have done from the very beginning. This is cool. This is really, really cool. I'm honestly really happy with this whole kind of structure, and what they should have been doing from the very beginning is really figuring out ways to make gamers enjoy their products that they've purchased and really set the standard for what it needs to be. With this sort of area going forward, 60 FPS, even in current gen AAA titles, should be the standard. We cannot go back to 30 FPS. It makes no conceivable sense whatsoever. Maybe back then on the PS4 and even before then, but when you look at what we have right now and the power that we have, the idea of 30 FPS makes zero sense. Do not take graphical fidelity for the way a game feels and plays when you put your hands on the controller. Graphics are great, but frame rate is what makes the game and what gives you that fluidity of motion and provides you that feedback when you're playing the game directly. Once you hit 60, you never go back to 30. And once you get to 120, everything else just seems ridiculously slow. So you know what? Let me know what you guys think in the comments section down below. Will you ever go back to 30 FPS? Is Microsoft making the right calls here? And do you think they can do more to standardize 60 FPS across the board for games to come in the future? Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate all of you. If you like the content, go to subscribe. You can check me out also on Twitch and Twitter, or right here on this YouTube channel. Like I said before, enjoy tonight's stream of Counter-Strike Global Offensive at 8:30 Eastern, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one.
Fucking bullshit! Son of a bitch! Bullshit, Don Gogan!